Well, I think it'd be tremendous. Obviously, for our program, it would be amazing, and it would help in a variety of ways, but also I do think it would be great for the sport of women's basketball. I mean, I think people want the upsets. People get excited about the Florida Gulf Coast, and why not let them get excited about the Iowa Hawkeyes after tomorrow night?
Third row left.
Coach, can you talk a little bit about dealing with Notre Dame's balance offensively? And is there a certain area you want them to shoot from? I mean, do you want to force them to take a lot of three-pointers?
You know, it's impressive. Their balance is something that I really love, because it's something that we try to stress in our basketball team. And I think all good basketball teams have that balance, have that inside-outside attack. But yeah, we would love to force them to take more outside shots. You know, yesterday I think they had 56 paint points, and it's hard to win a game when you're giving up that many high percentage shots.
Back row.
Coach, you look at Notre Dame, their only loss was at home against Baylor, so they have not lost on the road. They've beaten Connecticut twice at their place, at Tennessee. You guys are hosting. How do you make it tough for Notre Dame to be playing here? And it seems that they're not rattled on the road, but how do you try to get them rattled tomorrow?
Every streak comes to an end sometime. I mean, they've won 27 in a row, and you know that's got to get boring, doesn't it, for them? So, you know, maybe they'll take it for granted. You know, maybe they'll be in a situation where, you know, they're the highly favored. I mean, there's nobody in America that's betting on the Iowa Hawkeyes except for those women that are in that basketball locker room right now. But I told them there's going to be a lot of people cheering for them, though, and behind them to win this game, because I think everybody would like to see an upset like that.
Second row left.
How do you go about, because one thing that Notre Dame will do is they're going to go on some sort of run. They're going to go on a spurt, and the teams that can stay competitive and seem to handle that better. How will you go about that as far as, timeouts or whatever, trimming down a big run by Notre Dame?
Well, you only have so many timeouts that you can use, so yes, that's the first thing you think of. But also, I think changing up your defense is another. Trying to change the looks that they're getting through changing your defense has got to be the next thing, because you can't just keep burning timeouts. You're going to run out of those. You know, hopefully getting a spark like Melissa provided for us last night, and getting the crowd into the game through our own offensive production would also be really good.
Third row left.
Can you talk a little bit about the rebounding and just how critical of an area that will be tomorrow night?
Right, we talked about that with our team. It is really one of the keys, in my opinion, because Notre Dame is such a good rebounding team, and they have a lot of people that hit the boards. You know, last night we didn't do a very good job on the rebounds, but it didn't hurt us because they didn't make us pay for them. Tomorrow, Notre Dame is quite capable of making us pay for them, and so we've got to make a conscious effort of boxing out, getting a body on somebody. You know, last night Wilson was a load to box out. She had us outweighed by a lot, and she was a tough, tough person to box out, and give her the credit for doing a great job in there.
Front row right.
Lisa, what's the difference between, say, a team that, I mean, it's the same thing I ask these kids, between a team that makes the NCAA maybe, or is on the verge of making the NCAA, and the teams like Notre Dame that are sort of perennial Sweet 16 kind of teams. Not necessarily like the elite teams, but just can make that extra step. I mean, what do you guys have to do to kind of make that extra step?
I think it's consistency all year long, because if you're consistent all year long, then you tend to get those top four seeds. And we all know if we have those top four seeds, our ability to advance in the NCAA tournament is a lot stronger, a lot more likely. And so I think just having that consistent play all year long gets you the higher RPI, and will get you the higher seed and give you the easier path to the Sweet 16. You know, Notre Dame certainly has that. You know, I think you have to have consistency in not only your wins, but I mean, they just score at an unbelievable rate, and they defend too. So having both sides of that is excellent. They just have so many different people that can score. But in my opinion, it's just having that consistent output all year long in the win-loss column.
Back row.
Coach, what did it mean last night for you guys to win, first time in a couple years, an NCAA tournament game, but not just to win an NCAA tournament game, winning it here at home? I mean, what did it mean for you and the team?
Yeah, and winning it big too. That was pretty fun as well, and being able to have the opportunity to actually enjoy the last couple of minutes and not sit on pins and needles, but to enjoy it. It meant a lot to our players, you know, our seniors. Again, it gives them another opportunity to wear the Iowa uniform and to come play in Carver-Hawkeye Arena. But yeah, we want to win on the national stage, and last night again proved to us and the Hawkeye fans that we can do that.
Third row center.
Coach, if you're looking for the upset tomorrow night, how big a role will three-point shooting play?
Well, I think that we're going to have to find a way to score with them. I mean, they just are explosive offensively. And so we've got to knock down shots. We've got to hit those threes tomorrow. I think that's important for us to be able to do that. And, you know, we have to force them into taking some more contested shots. Again, if they get those type of paint points, you know, yes, they're going to take some threes, and they're definitely going to make some threes. They've got good three-point shooters. But I think we'd rather have them shooting from there with a hand in the face than in the paint right now.
Any other questions?